Hello everyone, welcome back to Bastion. Now, this pipe will start a very interesting mission, probably my favorite part in the game, but before I'm going to do that, actually, what does Zulf have to say?
Zulf doesn't touch the thing. Says the god of commotion is no children's toy.
Well, apparently we now have some, one of those weird, annoying iron bulls in the Bastion. Brilliant. Just brilliant.
The Ura feared the gods. We turned them into toys, put their faces on our walls.
But yeah, before we use the pipe, I want to have a look at those new training missions. Oh, that's the Bastion.
That's Zolwood Grove. A nice, quiet place to show a musket a good time.
That's for the musket. This is for
that's
the hammer.
That's scrapyard, where folks got to smash things and call it community service.
And this is the next regular core mission, yeah.
That's the Langston River. Used to cut all the way to the wild. Think it was bad then.
And this is for the shield.
That's the Bullhead Court. Folks defended themselves there with shields, not words.
I'm going to do this first. Now, the repeater I'm probably not going to use at all.
No place better than Trapper Shingle for learning to tread light and shoot straight.
But
Trappers had to tread real carefully, or else take a nasty fall.
I still want to try and get
by clearing out the targets while not clearing out the floor.
I still want to try and get second prize in this, because I think then I will get an upgrade for the rifle that can be used later. This is very hard, or I just haven't figured out how to do it properly yet. I think this is the way to do it.
Any good trapper knows never to take a step till the time is right.
I wonder how many I have to hit. First prize is very much doable. But when I played through this game, I never managed to get first prize in this mission, in this training. Second prize, I think, and that's what I'm going for right now. This is only third prize now. Oh, 48. Damn it. No. No, this is just a bore. I don't care. Perhaps I will.
To think a rickety place like the Shingle survived. So little else did.
I will come back to that later. Perhaps I'll even upgrade the repeater for it. But right now I want to save the fragments for something more useful. Now this I do want to complete.
The city's unwanted things all met their end in the yard. Folks who fouled up will do their time here. Smashing things to bits.
This is fun. Obviously, the objective for this is very simple: smash things.
The quicker they work, the sooner they can go. Folks learn to plant their feet and put their backs into it.
Yeah, it's destroy 100 items and then. The price is dependent on how quick you are. goddammit, there is nothing else to destroy.
A good day smashing to feed a family for a week.
Yeah, I think this was my own mistake. 27 seconds, oh, that's tough. I don't think this special ability that you can win in this is that good, but I want to try again anyway.
Kid pays another visit to the scrapyard for old time's sake.
Yeah, let's do it.
You worked too slow and all you got was a sore back.
This is very tough if you don't upgrade the hammer at all. I have upgraded it once.
Some folks invested their earnings to forge even better hammers.
Yes, I did it.
The strongest, fastest folks earn more than their fair share.
Very nice. I'll have a look at that special ability later.
Kids worked the yard before, but that time he just plain destroyed it.
Now the musket training. I'll have a go.
Ever felt this old wood gourd like picking up broken glass barehanded? As old wood grove, marshals learn to make every shot count.
I have actually done that today, picking up broken glass barehanded, because I lately destroyed my mirror. Yeah, I have to take care of that soon. So yeah, how does this work again?
The trick was to pop all those nasty gourds without wasting ammo. Most marshals didn't get far in the first few tries.
Yeah, push those targets off the ledge while using as few shots as possible.
In a single shot. Funny thing about muskets is they work best up close. It took a keen eye, not an itchy trigger finger.
Yeah, second try's not too bad for the first try. 15 shots. I think I can do that.
Kid takes a little personal time for just him and his favorite musket.
Now, how to do that? Seems to be going well.
Plenty of gourds to go around, even now.
Four more shots to spare.
Fine-tune your muskets to get better results. The best of the best.
Yes, excellent.
A few shots.
I think I still want to keep the grenades as my special ability.
Kid probably
for now.
Could have made himself marshal one day.
And now there is the shield training left. Like I said, I don't care about this one. This I can do, but it will require some concentration. I'll try once or twice, and if it doesn't work right now, I will come back.
Shake in Ceylandia. Some used to take the bullhead trial.
In this, you have to defeat enemies only with your shield, only by countering their attacks.
Survive the trial without taking a scratch, you walk away a free man.
Like this. while of course taking as few hits as possible.
The Bullhead trial taught folks three things. First, a good defense is a good offense. Second, you gotta always watch your back. Third, ain't no godlike bull up there gonna save you.
Have to get the timing just right, obviously.
Some folks wound up taking the coward's way out.
Oof, that takes as a hit. That counts as a hit taken. Okay. Going well so far. With those turrets it's fairly easy, because their attacks are predictable. In this, those squirts can be a bit challenging, because their attacks are difficult to predict. Well, I did it actually this time. Ah, goddammit. Took two hits on that one.
The smarter ones knew when to just step aside and let things go.
Now I can probably get him to fall off the ledge. If I do this correctly. Like this perhaps? No. Now it should work. No, it didn't. God damn it, just fall off the ledge. Taking too many hits. Now, how can I do this? This last enemy is ruining everything. Now, come over here. And please fall off the ledge. If you don't mind. I think I've screwed this up. Yeah, now he's gone.
The kid pulls through in fine form.
Second prize. Now, the reward in this. It's actually... a lot of fragments. Very good. I'll try again once more and then I will move on.
Court is back in session for the kid. Old ritual for when folks believed there was this godlike bull watching over them. Had to make do with nothing but a shield.
I'll just have to be careful in this and concentrate. I imagine this is rather boring to watch. I'll try and get it right this time. And if it doesn't work, then I will come back to this later. Really, with the turrets and windpack, it's no problem. But that scumbag at the end, that really was a pain in the ass. Now for the squirts. Some more turrets. Now this is where the scumbag comes in again. Come over here, and fall off. Him to come over there and then over here, yeah, like this, and now this way. Yes, there he goes.
The kid pulls it off like it was nothing.
Very nice. More fragments are always useful. Oh, that was a lot. That was a lot.
There's a hint of pride in his eye when he gets back, and more than a hint in mine.
That's enough training for now. Yeah, this is still fine. Something heavy for the hammer. No more damage, I think is what I want.
The marshal learned to pack those shells full of fire.
So now, let's have a look at this.
Poor kid collapses after just one drag. The past. Only good thing ever come out of the past is history.
Now this may seem like just a random fighting mission, but there is actually more to it.
The past catches up with the kid. Hardly had a moment's rest since all this started.
Yeah, so this is where we get some backstory on our protagonist. With the musket, those scumbags really aren't a problem anymore.
Fair to say he's led a hard life. Supposing what he says in his sleep ain't no lie.
Eighteen reflections remain. That means that there are 18 waves of enemies remaining. And with each one we get some... Yeah, like I said, some backstory. Assuming we can survive. but I think we will.
He never knew his old man, but he had his mama to take care of. Frail thing with pure white hair like his.
So this is basically nothing but fighting in this area. But yeah, one of my favorite parts of this game.
Having his mama's hair did the kid no favors while he was growing up, but he learned to hold his own out there. School ain't working out, so the kid signs up for a turn on the rippling walls. Make his mama some money.
And also, of course, this is an opportunity to collect money and to get experience. Took a bit of a beating there.
Thanks to folks like the kid, the walls kept Ceylania safe from whatever's out there. The elements, the Ura, you name it.
Later on, we will actually see what is out there. Or at least what is out there now. Perhaps it was different before the calamity.
Once the kid done his time, he hurried on home. Turns out his mama's time was done too.
Whoa, that's a big one. That's what she said, also.
The city had nothing for him. The money he'd been sending home was nowhere to be found, neither.
So far, this isn't too difficult.
So what'd the kid do? Why he went right on back to the walls for another 5 years?
My favorite tactic still works very well. Run around in a big circle and... Oh, I completed a challenge or whatever this is called. Well, that's cool. Yeah, just run around in a big circle, dodge enemy attacks and shoot them with something. Both the bow and the musket work very well.
Nobody's ever volunteered for a second shift on the walls.
If I remember correctly, there is at least another
kid learned to fend for himself.
Iron bull in this mission, maybe more. And as you can see, the ground is slowly being chopped away. Obviously, this is supposed to become more difficult in time.
Standing with the marshals, they trusted him to scout out farther than anybody.
Now, how many reflections remain? I didn't pay attention.
conditions, the ground beneath them shuddered, cracked, and split apart.
Oh, only 7. Okay. I can do that. Will you die already? There you go. Almost forgot to use my grenades.
You saw nothing where the world used to be. The calamity happened just like that.
Yeah. The bow is really powerful now.
Kid had to work with was his hammer and the clothes on his back.
Yeah, the bow is very powerful now, and the musket is also doing nicely, so yeah, I think I will use this combination for a little while longer. But there will be some variation later on, don't worry.
Through twisted streets, he ran with nothing but the city crest and an old stranger's voice to guide him.
Will you stop destroying the ground, please? I still have to walk on it. God, they take a lot of damage.
Will it finally arrive at Ceylandia's vaulted safe haven? He and no one else. But then, all he got was more thankless work from a man who ain't even asked his name.
Yeah, this should be nearly done.
Sure, I may be the one who dreamt up the walls and the bastion, but the kid made him real. Not me.
Oh yeah, there's the wolf. And down I go. Ah, this thing is annoying. There he goes.
I'd say I'll never forget him, or what he's doing, what he's done. I surely would.
Excellent. Reflection complete. Now it's possible to replay the reflection, but obviously I'm not going to do that right now. What was the one that I completed this one?
The marshals kept the city's peace. They can rest easy now.
Yeah. I will complete those in due time. We have quite a bit of money now. quite a bit of fragments. Something for the musket.
Finders keepers.
I think that's all I want for now. I'm not at level 4 yet. Faster reload or better long range damage? No, I want to use the musket for melee combat, no, close range combat, so faster reload would be useful.
You gotta get rid of the recoil.
Yeah.
That ought to make those fangs sink in nice and deep.
Yeah, I'm improving the repeater just to have another shot at the training mission. And the hammer, not right now. Yeah. But yeah, I think I will. Or is there something else to do? No, there really isn't. So, I'm going to end the video here. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Until then, take care.